to God who's the head of my life, to my pastor, Pastor Reed, to my daddy, there's been a lot to me on Father's Day, to all the other preachers that's here today. You may be wondering if I'm going to preach, but I wonder if you're going to pray. First of all, I don't know where she is, but I know my mother's here somewhere. I know she's crying somewhere. Mama, where you at? So, if you have your Bibles, I'm going to go to a very familiar story of the Bible in the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 17, starting with the 11th verse. If you have it, say amen. And the Bible reads, and it came to pass, as he went to Jerusalem, that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, go show yourselves unto the priests. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice glorified God and fell down on his face at his feet, giving him thanks, and he was a Samaritan. And Jesus answered and said, were there not 10 cleansed, but where are the 9? There are not found that return to give glory to God, save the stranger. And he said unto them, arise, go thy way, thy faith hath made thee whole. But I want to go back to the 15th verse. And it said, and one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice glorified God.
Hallelujah.
And fell down on his feet, on his face, at his feet, giving him thanks. And he was a Samaritan. Just for a minute, I want to talk about what happened to your manners. What happened to your
life? Heaven. Yes, sir.
Since August of 2008, I have worked in the Memphis City school system, and this generation of children has changed drastically today. I remember that when I went to school, you didn't cuss out no teacher. You didn't talk back to no teacher. You didn't tell the teacher what you was and wasn't going to do, because I had a dad that, if the teacher called him and said I was acting up, it only took him 2 or 3 minutes to get up to the school. But as I stand here and look back over my childhood life, there's no doubt in my mind that the reason I am able to stand here is because God has blessed me with 2 wonderful parents. But there are 2 things about my parents I need to let you know. My parents believe in the scripture, Proverbs 13:24. If you spread a rod, you'll spoil the child. My parents didn't mind every now and again when I was out of line, reaching out and touching me in order to let me know that I needed to get myself in order. I had parents who taught me.
Come on!
This may, in fact, like I already said, may be a new term to this present generation.
Yes, sir.
Yes, I was taught that you didn't say yes and no to another. You were to address them with yes, ma'am, and no, ma'am, and yes, sir, and no, sir. But it behooved me not to get into grown folks' conversation, because if I got into grown folks' conversation and my daddy was around, he would holler out, son, don't you hear grown folks talking? And if you do it again, I'm going to smack the taste out your mouth. But I'm glad today that I still have taste in my mouth. It was also taught that when you walked into a room of people, that it was courteous that you speak to everyone. You didn't go to Ethel Louise Patterson's house and walk in there and then speak, because she was her father's son. I didn't sleep with you last night. But there are two words that everybody should know, and I think they call it the magic words. And there was please and thank you. My parents told me to always say please whenever I was asking someone for something. When I look to see what please means, the dictionary states that please is used as a function word to express politeness or emphasis in a request. The other word I was always instructed to say was thank you. Saying thank you was simply your way of showing gratitude and that you were appreciative of what has been done for you. For the last 2 years, I have watched my son grow up. I have watched him learn to walk. I have watched him learn to crawl, and I have watched him learn to say his first words. Usually, in babies, one of their first words is daddy. But after a period of time, he began to say the word thank you. It amazes me that us grown folks have the audacity to be thankful for things, but a two-year-old child can understand the simple courtesy of saying thank you when something is given or done for them. But Pastor, the church is full of ungrateful people. You see their praises go up, they sit there playing with their nails, playing with their hair, making sure they clothes right. But Pastor, we have that wake up every morning and don't say a mumbling word. That God put clothes on our bed and we don't say a mumbling word. He put food on our table and we don't say a mumbling word. He puts a roof on our table and we don't say a mumbling word. God put gas in our car for us and we still don't say a mumbling word. But I made up in my mind, every time I get a chance, every time I get an opportunity to say thank you to God, I am going to open up my mouth. I am going to raise my hands and I am going to tell God thank you. Is there anybody here that just wants to tell God thank you? I just wonder what the church would be like if church folks would begin to give God sincere thanks and praises. We would have millionaires, successful business owners, houses paid off, cars paid off. And I tell you, God would just begin to rain down blessings constantly. But we are so quick to enjoy the content of the gift, but we forget the gift. But we are so quick to pray, but slow to praise. I'll read you and tell them, don't forget your manners.
Don't forget your manners.